In this video, we will talk about actually the whole National Commission for the Backward Classes. So how you proceed, whatever is the important articles, how a state actually drives the power for forming the backward classes, we will discuss. We will also discuss the evolution of the backward classes. Actually, it actually relates with the Indira Sahni versus Union of India case and others. So that is the main evolution of the actually the National Commission for Backward Classes after the Supreme Court judgment. And then we will talk about the which article actually comes under for backward classes, what are the functions, powers and composition. So this is in this video we will talk about. So before we move forward for backward classes, we have to talk the actually the some important articles. So the first article is the Article 340. So the president, in the Article 340, the president may by order appoint a commission consist of such person as he thinks fit, means the president thinks fit, not any other, parliament not, but the president thinks fit to investigate the commission of the socially and educationally backward classes of citizen. So this comes under the Article 320. On the basis of this article, the various commissions has been formed, including I think three. So there are the Kelkar committee, Kaka Kelkar committee and Mandal committee is the very very famous commission, has been formed on the basis of this article. Now actually how a state drives its power to actually give the reservation or take some affirmative action toward the socially and educationally backward classes. Remember that actually it is not about the economic classes has not been provided, but the socially and educationally classes. There is no clear cut definition I have found about the socially and educationally backward classes, but the OBC is considered as the socially and educationally backward classes, and whatever if the government in future will allow, then will be also considered as the socially and educationally backward classes. Basically we can derive the meaning that those who are socially backward or not in the mainstream in the social strata. So this is basically educationally means not adequate representation either in the educational field, in the actually the you can say the services, central services, state services or other. So this is you can say that the socially and educationally backward. Now another is the Article 15 clause 4. It comes under Article Fundamental Right Part 3 of the Constitution of India. So remember that what is said that state is empowered to make any special provision for advancement of any socially and educationally backward classes of citizen. This is very very important word, classes of citizen, means there is nothing confined. Classes of citizen means if there is any future, anything will happen and the government felt that this is a classes of citizen, need to be provided this something or affirmative action need to be taken, that will be considered as the classes of citizen. So this comes on and including scheduled castes and scheduled tribes also. Another important is the Article 60, which is also a fundamental right under part 3, in which word said that the state can provide the reservation of appointments or post in favor of any backward classes if the any backward classes found that is not adequately represented either in the central services, state services or any of the services. So this is all about. So this is on the basis from these two articles actually a state drive its powers to take affirmative action for the any socially and educationally backward classes and popularly known as the OBC other backward classes. So now we will discuss actually the some few cases and the actually the some commission which is appointment related to the educationally socially and educationally backward classes. As I have told you, the Article 340 and Article 16 and the 15 clause 4. Now what happened after independence, actually other backward classes is not represented or there is no reservation at all, but there are the provisions. So what happened, there is the first backward classes actually the commission was appointed by the president notification, and this commission under article, as I have told you, under Article 300 40 of the Constitution of India, which said that the president has the power to actually appoint a commission for the socially and educationally backward classes. So this actually commission appointed on 29th January 1953. And chairman is the Kaka Kelekar. This is the famous name, as you know, the Kalkar Committee is for the. And this commission actually submitted the report on 30 March 1955 to the president. And under Article 340, there are provision also that the president has, when there is a commission submit some report to the president, then the president has to table in the parliament, in the both houses of parliament. So this table. So what are the recommendations of this Kelkar Committee? The first Kelkar Committee said that caste should be the criteria for the backwardness. Remember that everyone is trying to oppose that caste should not be the criteria, but the recommendation of Kelkar Committee said that the caste should be the criteria for backwardness. Another is the it identified, Kelkar Committee identified the 2,399 backward castes. Out of that, 837 is the most backward classes of citizens. Another is what said that there should be a caste-wise census should be held, and which actually held in the 1961. Another is the treating all women as backward. This is the important. Treating all women as backward is also one of the recommendation of the Kelkar Committee. Another is the reservation to the socially and educationally backward classes up to 70%. Up to 70% in all the technical means IIT, there are the IIT, IIM, and the professional institution like the Delhi University, in their state also there are the professional institution. So that is the technical and the professional institution should be given, and reservation of 20% should be given. Another is the hierarchy should follow. Hierarchy means, as you know, in one caste there are the various sub castes. So what happened, suppose this is a caste, let's say Baniya. So in there are the 1, 2, 3, 4. So suppose the 4 is the most backward. So there should be a hierarchy. After 4, then 3, then 2, then 1 should be follow. So you not said the Baniya is the whole about the just like in Bihar. So that should not be considered as the socially and educationally, but the hierarchy should follow. So this is the recommendation of the Kelkar Commission, which is submitted to the President of India. Now we will talk about the most contentious and which actually led to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court order came, and Indira Sani is a big name, as you know, and which actually kept the reservation. So now let's talk about the Mandal Commission. What happened that the Kelkar Commission, after the recommendation of Kelkar Commission, actually the central government rejected the recommendation of the commission. As you know, there are the some actually recommendation like the 20% recommendation for the all institution to the socially and educationally. So if you compare with the SC and ST, then it is around the 90% reservation. So the merit is not the criteria at all. And other recommendation is the considered all women as the backward classes. So that are the, these are the some vague provision, and that's why they rejected by the central government. What happened after that? The Mandal Commission, second commission related to the socially and educationally backward commission, by notification of the president under Article 340 was appointed. So Mandal Commission. So this Mandal Commission is very, very famous, and it was appointed in 1st January 1979. Remember that this is a national holiday on which actually the commission was appointed. And this commission is appointed by the Morarji Desai government. Chairman, actually the chairperson of this commission is the B.P. Mandal. Full form of B.P. is the Bindeswari Prasad Mandal. Bindeswari Prasad Mandal, it is also a former chief minister of Bihar and a member of Lok Sabha. So this is very, very important. Mandal Commission submitted the report on December 1980. So remember that it almost around the, this is all about. So this is the recommendation. Now what are the recommendations? Recommendations are very, very important. It actually considered that 52% population in India which is actually the socially and educationally backward, include Hindus and non-Hindus and excluding the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. So this is the first recommendation. Another is that it actually identified the 3743 as the backward caste, and now around more than 5000 is considered as the socially and educationally backward. 27% reservation for the other backward classes. So 27 reservation for the other backward classes. So here you can say the word OBC. So this is all about. Another is the, this reservation should be extended to promotion at all levels. But the Supreme Court has clearly said after the Indira Sahni judgment that promotion cannot and reservation cannot be extended to the promotion as well. These are the some recommendation of the Mandal Commission. So what happened in a decade? So this is the 1980, and in 1919 actually the after the commission recommendation, actually the VP Singh government declared the 27% reservation in government jobs for the other backward classes. So this is done by the VP Singh actually declared in the 1919, and that led to the contentious issue. Now we will discuss what happened, why Indira Sahni went to the Supreme Court of India. So after that, what happened that actually the Mandal Commission recommended, and also the government declared that 27% reservation would be given to the other backward classes. But the question actually arises when then the in 1991 actually the Narasimha Rao government introduced the two changes in that. Firstly, to have preference to the poorer sections among the OBCs itself. So this is, so whatever is the more poor is the main criteria for the actually the OBC determination. Another is the 10% reservation in jobs for the poorer section is for higher caste, and this is for the basically the those who are the economically section, so economic basis. So here is the economic section actually is introduced by the Narasimha Rao government. So this led to the friction in the actually in the government because of the upper caste. Actually 10% reservation when given to the upper caste, this led to the resentment. So after that what happened, the Indira Sahni actually challenged this in the Supreme Court of India on the basis of 2 points, and the famous case is the Indira Sahni versus Union of India 1992, because of the judgment came in the 1992. So what Indira Sahni said that in the debt actually in the against the reservation of this reservation. So what said that? The first main argument of the Indira Sahni that extension of reservation violated the equality of opportunity. If you look at the OBC 27% reservation, SC/ST around the 51-52% at that time, and now 10% is the 62 and up to the 65%. So this is completely against the equality of opportunity, because in the name of caste and etc, actually those who are on the actually those who are actually getting the married, they are not uplifted, but those person who are uplifted, these are the main argument. Another is the caste was not a reliable indicator for the reservation. This not seems good, because if you look at the SC, especially the Bhimrao Ambedkar, not on the basis of economic provision that was discriminated with the Bhimrao Ambedkar, but on the basis of caste. So this is not a reliable. So here is the Indira Sahni judgment. Another is the efficiency of the public institution at risk. As you know, there are the some argument given by the people as well. Okay, because of the SC/ST is more coming, OBC is more coming, and reservation peoples are more coming. So public institution efficiency and the actually the government is not country is not developing, and that's why the underdeveloped country, and we are the underdeveloped country. That's why the argument behind this reservation is the main criteria for the underdevelopment of country, and that's why the reservation should be abolished. So these are the three arguments on the basis of which actually the Indira Sahni challenged this reservation. Now the judgment came. After that, the judgment came, and this judgment given by the 9-judge bench. So remember that 9 judges seated in the and gave the judgment. I think in history actually this is the highest judgment, highest judge bench, I think. So this is all about. So what happened that actually it upholded the 20% 27% reservation for the other backward classes. So this is all about. And actually said that the caste is a reliable indicator for giving the and consider backwardness of any classes of citizens. So this is in the judgment of the Indira Somani 1992 versus Union of India. Another said that the court actually rejected the reservation of 10% reservation for the upper caste. So remember that it actually rejected the 10% reservation for the upper caste introduced by the government. So actually on the basis of this, actually this government, this present government, BJP government, actually introduced the 10%, and that's why there is a chaos or there is an assumption that if this judgment has not been upheld by the Supreme Court, then why this actually reservation will be appointed on the basis of the economically weaker section. Actually matter in the Supreme Court, whatever is the judgment will come, we will discuss. Another is that, as I have told you, another is the creamy layer should be excluded from the reservation. There is no definition of the creamy layer, but the creamy layer are those, as you know, creamy means those who are actually already uplifted, and this is all about. So if there are any constitutional post and their deduction should not be taken, those who are the exceeding the income, let's say 4 lakh 6 lakh, or this is all about. So what do you mean, this is the meaning of the creamy layer. So another is the no reservation in promotion. This should be reservation at the appointment level only, said by the Supreme Court of India. Another is the total reservation quota should not exceed 50% except in extraordinary situation. And that's why recently you have seen that the parliamentarians and some members and the party itself, even the BJP itself, actually demanding to look at the matter of the 50% cap. So this is very, very important. And which was said at the 50%, and Maratha reservation actually declared unconstitutional. One of the reasons for declaring the unconstitutional is actually it breaches the 50% limit set by the Supreme Court. And recently in the Maratha judgment, Supreme Court also declined to look at the matter of 50% cap. So this is very, very important in some extraordinary situation. So as I have told you, we will talk about the evolution of the National Commission for Backward Classes, which comes in this judgment. What said that the permanent statutory body should be established for the other backward classes, and that lead to the evolution of the National Commission for Backward Classes. Now so far we have discussed all the matter. So now this is the, so now we will directly come to the actually the National Commission for Backward Classes, and then there are the one commission for the subcategorization under the Rohni. Actually the Justice Rohni has been appointed of the government. So this is the basic information. So whatever will come, we will take up the matter in future. As you know, the judgment came in the Indira Somani versus Union of India. So by following the order, actually the government appointed the Ram Nandan committee basically to identify the creamy layer among the other backward classes, and it submitted the report in 1993. So this is all about. And what happened, the by following the order actually which gave that this should form the national backward classes. So National Commission for Backward Classes was established in 1993 by an act of National Commission for Backward Classes 1993 act. So that act continues to, so this 1993 that act actually continued to the 2018. So this has given the statutory status to the backward classes. After that, what happened, after the 102nd constitutional amendment, actually the government gave the constitutional status to the National Commission for Backward Classes. So till today we have discussed the first commission for the national backward, main recommendation. After that, the second recommendation, Mandal Commission, Indira Somani case, what are the arguments of Indira Somani and why that reservation, and there are the some judgments. Now we have discussed the order of the following judgment. The government actually appointed this commission and established the national. Now we will come at the directly to the National Commission for Backward Classes, actually what are the main composition, functions, tenure, etc. So now let's talk about the National Commission for Backward Classes. I have told you how actually, so basically the Indira Somani judgment is the main thing which actually said that there should be a permanent commission for the backward classes, for the inclusion as well as exclusion for the backward classes, and with this judgment came in 1992 in Indira Sahni versus Union of India case. So this is all about. So now what happened? After that, actually the permanent National Commission for Backward Classes actually established, and that is established on 14th August 1993. From, if we will talk about, almost 28 years ago, one day is left. So 28 years ago, so this is all about. And by passing an Act of Parliament, National Commission for Backward Classes in 1993. So when by passing the parliamentary parliament, then that time actually it is a statutory commission, a statutory body till 2018. So after that the changes done by the government. So from the 1993 actually the 2000 National Commission for Backward Classes Act 1993 is repealed. In 2017 what happened, this actually has been repealed, this act has been repealed in 2017. So what happened in 2000, actually government introduces the bill and repeal. After that the 102nd constitutional amendment actually tabled in the parliament and passed by the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and assented by the President of India. So in 2000 government introduced 100. What is the main aim? Main aim is to provide the constitutional status to the backward classes and introduce the Article 338B and Article 342A. So this is all about. What is in the Article 338B? Actually there should be a commission for the constitutional commission for the actually the National Commission for the Backward Classes. And in Article 422, actually the list actually formed by the central government. So that is all about for the other backward classes. So currently if you talk about what is the status of this commission currently it is a constitutional body and not a statutory body, and this constitutional body under 102nd constitutional amendment. As I have told you, all the things which is related to the very very important to the National Commission for Backward Classes. So now let's talk about the composition, means the structure. So if you talk about total 5 members in this commission, which includes the chairperson, and the current chairperson of National Commission for Backward Classes is the Dr. Bhagwan Lal Sahni. Another is the vice chairperson, and the current vice chairperson is the Dr. Lokesh actually Kumar Prajapati. And other 3 members which actually related to this field as well. So if you talk about the other 3 members, then the Sudha Yadav, Kolsendra Singh, and if you talk about the Thalozu Achari. So these are the 3 members in this. Remember that appointment of these all the members, including the chairperson, vice chairperson and the 3 members, done by the President of India under his hand and seal. And remember that everything, if you 10-year structure, everything actually as the president may rule by determine. So everything is lies in the hands of president. Another is the functions and powers. If you talk about, as I have told you, the main function is to look into the matter of the other backward classes, or you can say the socially and educationally backward classes. So if you look at the Indira Sahni judgment versus Union of India, this has been done, also said by the Supreme Court, that the, which is a main function, inclusion in and exclusion from the list of the communities notified as backward classes. Why this has been done? Basically, if someone exclusion, why exclusion? Basically inclusion, if there is any most backward which is exclusively actually excluded from the list, then the National Commission has the task basically to recommend the government to include this, and government will take an amendment in the constitution, and then by the this is exclusion has also the power actually the matter, because of the actually some of the actually entered into the All India Services or creamy layer like condition applied in the OBC category. So that's why the exclusion from ANSO. So this actually maintain the balance actually where targeted delivery of reservation went to the beneficiaries. This helps the National Commission for Backward Classes. If we talk about the, as I have told you, under Article 330B, there should be a National Commission for, and if you talk about the clause 5, to investigate, so it shall be the duty of the National Commission for Backward Classes to investigate, monitor all matters related to the socially and economically backward. If there is any threat or everything like that, then the commission has the full power related to that. Another is the to inquire into the complaints related to the socially and educationally backward classes. If any member suppose if any socially or educationally actually take a complaint to the National Commission, then the National Commission has the power to look into the complaints related to the socially and educationally backward classes. So if you talk about the another power and functions, then to participate and advise on the socio-economic development related to the socially and educationally backward classes. So this is the another job of the National Commission for backward classes. Remember that socio-economic development to the related to the socially and educationally backward classes. Another is the make a report and present to the president. Actually, what happened that there are the various commission actually which actually form the annual report, and each actually submitted to the president, and president has the power to submit that actually in the house. So this is the process. So that actually the report is the annual report, and if the president demand some another report, let's say 1 year, for 2 year, or let's say for 6 months, then also the commission has to submit a report. So there is no clear cut to actually said that there should be a fixed annual report. Another is the to make recommendation related to the socially and educationally backward classes to the states and union. Suppose if there is any recommendation, and remember that this recommendation is only advisory. Means if the commission has make any recommendation, that is not binding on the government. It is up to the government either to accept the recommendation of these backward classes or not accept. So this is completely up to the state government as well as the union government. Remember that for state there is a separate national commission for backward classes. Another thing, and while inquiring the cases, commission has the full power of a civil court. Means actually they can summon, they can actually make a report, or they can charge even the any of the which is related to the socially and economically backward classes. Now the most important article in this actually 102nd constitutional amendment and recent issue is related to the article 342A. You can watch my previous video actually to understand the issues related to the article 348A, link in the description. So what is article A said that the president actually can define the socially and educationally and can release the list of the socially and educationally backward classes even for the state, but with the consultation with the governor. So in the Maratha reservation what happened, actually Supreme Court interpreted and upholded this article and said that the state has no power. But that's why recently what that this 107th constitutional amendment actually introduced by the government in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha and passed by both the houses, now the assent is required. And that's why, so this said that they actually restore the powers of the government. Another is the article 366 26C. So what happened that, as I have told you, there is no clear cut definition of socially and educationally backward classes. So in the article 366-26 that whatever president determined related to the union government, not to the state government. Now state has the full power under article 127 constitutional amendment to make its own list. But 366-26, president may determine whatever president will classify as a socially and educationally backward classes or other backward classes will be considered as the socially and educationally backward classes under article 366-26C. So this is all about the National Commission for Backward Classes. Remember that advice or recommendation is only advisory, not binding on the government. And this comes under the article 338B. What said that there should be a commission, there should be a national commission for backward classes. I have told you all the history from the Kelkar committee and then the Mandal commission, Indra Sani judgment, what are the arguments of Indra Sani, and that's why what is the judgment of the Supreme Court in 1992, and then actually the commission, and why the actually in 2018 the 102nd constitution, and now the current status of this commission is to basically a constitutional body. So this is all about of this video. Thank you guys, hope you like this video. You should subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.